the digital, it is a very commonly used word. Digital electronics is something we are going to talk about. So the subject what we are going to study is known as digital electronics. Now when it comes to what's the digital, it is a very commonly used word in day-to-day life. Suppose in a very layman point of view, if I am saying a device is a digital device or it is an analog device, what is the basic difference between a digital device and the analog devices? That the type of the output that a device or a system is actually producing. A device is said to be analog device if it produces its output that changes continuously with respect to time. Whereas if it comes to a digital device that doesn't change its output continuously with respect to time. One simple example I would like to give. Suppose you take example of a watch. When it comes to watch, you know, normally you have two kind of watch. One is analog watch, one is digital watch. But when it comes to analog watch, all of you know that as in a day, as the time progresses, the output of that analog watch continuously keep on changing. We are having three needles on that, right? So with respect to time, that is continuously changing. Whereas it comes to a digital watch, even if the time progresses in a day, that doesn't change continuously. We observe the variation in the output of the watch by after each second or each minute like that. But if you compare, in analog watch, the time is continuously changing. That second needle is continuously keep on rotating. That means it changes its output continuously. Whereas if you come to a digital watch, where there is some display device is there, it doesn't change its output continuously. However, you observe the output in some discrete steps, right? So that is what we mean by a digital device and an analog device. So once again, I'm saying that if a device, it changes its output continuously, it is known as analog device. Whereas if a device changes its output discrete wise, which is not in continuous way, that is known as a digital device. But that is what I mean by digital. But when I am attaching this word electronics to this, it means when this word electronics comes into picture, it means the concept of voltage and currents also comes into picture. Right? So whenever in particularly in the electronics field, as well as let's say in electrical engineering or electronics engineering, when we use the word signal, normally the signal is nothing but it is a form of way to represent the information. So whenever we say about electrical signal, normally that signal is, we mean by either it is a what? It is a voltage signal or it is a current signal. So the signal what we mean is normally it is a voltage signal or it's a current signal. But most generally we deal with what? The voltage signal. Now, when I'm saying that if a system is analog electronic system and if I'm saying a system is a digital electronic system, system is nothing but a circuit actually, analog electronic circuit or digital electronic circuit. The basic difference between an analog circuit and a digital circuit is the kind of input they takes, they process and they produces the output. I will say a system or a circuit is analog circuit if it takes analog signal input and process analog signal. Similarly, if I say it is a digital circuit or digital electronic system, it means it takes digital signal as input, process it and produces process digital signal. Now definitely, the question comes to your mind, what do we mean by an analog signal and what do we mean by a digital signal? The simple way to define this is a signal, that means I already told, signal means it is either a voltage signal or a current signal. A signal that changes continuously with respect to time is known as an analog signal. For example, a sinusoidal variation you can take or any random variation you can take if this axis is time, this axis is voltage, right? You see, at any moment of time, the signal is continuously keep on changing. And this system is sensitive to each and every amplitude and it will process this kind of signal and it will also produces a output that can be some kind of something like this, which is again analog in nature. In the sense, if the signal amplitude is continuously changing with respect to time, all changes are allowed. That is what we mean by analog signal. So a circuit that takes input as analog signal, process it and produces a processed analog signal, that is known as an analog circuit or analog system. Whereas if you come to digital electronic circuit, that as I am saying that it can take any kind of value here, right? Here this kind of flexibility is not available here. As far as our subject is concerned, when I am talking about digital electronic circuit, when I am talking about some signal if I am giving, So that voltage here in the strict sense comprises of only two values. It's a low value and a high value. So the signal that we are giving input to this particular circuit or the system is something look like this. Something like this, something like this, something like this. Where I'm saying that this voltage having two values. One is the high value, one is the low value. High value, low value like this. Of course, these are the points in these times. The signal is changing from one low value to high value. So let us say that this represents a 0 volt, this represents a 5 volts. So at any moment of time, if I'm observing this signal, I will say volt or 5 volt. Of course, you can ask me what is the amplitude of the signal at this instant, let us say T1 instant. What is the amplitude means? It is not defined what is the amplitude here. We will say the signal is making a transition or it is making a change from 5 volt to 0 volt. Similarly here, the signal is making a change from 0 volt to 5 volts. Right? So, a digital electronic circuit is something that takes this kind of signal input and produces again a signal which again comprises of only two levels, low level, high level, like this some kind of signal will produce. Right? So, this is what the basic difference between an analog electronic circuit and a digital electronic circuit. Naturally, you may ask that practically these kind of signals are very frequently we are getting in day-to-day life application. For example, if you take a temperature transducer or a pressure transducer, once you are giving the temperature here, if the temperature is continuously changing, now the output of this will also continuously changing. If this is a sensor or a transducer, whatever we say, if you give a changing temperature, the output of this also keep on changing. So it is of course analog signal. Now suppose if this kind of signal I want to process through a digital system or a digital electronic circuit, this system is totally insensitive to this kind of variation, because already I told that this is in a, this can process a signal which is digital in nature, which has to be this form. So of course, you may think that whether this is possible or not. Of course it is possible, but to do that, what you have to do is, this signal has to be passed through a block that is something known as analog to digital converter. By passing through this various block, analog, it is also comprised of various block. So the output of this analog to digital converter may look something like this, these kind of forms, and that has to be further processed and will again produces what? Again a digital signal. So without seeing much of the things about this, only thing we should know from here onwards after in the entire subject, that whenever I am talking regarding a signal or an input, it means that I am talking about a voltage signal, and that to be that voltage signal is having only two values. It's having a high value, it's having a low value. There is no intermediate value. So normally it is a convention we are following that if you are giving an analog signal to a ADC, the output what it is producing, the two levels, low level and high level, normally it turns out that the low level corresponds to 0 volt, high level corresponds to 5 volt. But it is not a strict rule that it has to be like this, but most general case we take these are the reference. Okay. See one thing, like normally you already this subject you might have studied in your BTEC course, but normally we never talks the input to the system is 0 volt or the input to the system is 5 volt. Normally what we talk is the input is 0, output is 1, something like this, only 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1 we used to talk. So what is those 0, 1 actually? Let us see that before we move to the further detail. So, what is the conclusion we drawn from this discussion is, the total in the entire subject, the type of signal what we'll discuss is having a voltage signal which is having only two levels like this. So, this is what we mean by low level, this is what we mean by high level. This corresponds to 5 volt actually. This corresponds to what? This is actually 0 volts. Now, it turns out it is always not convenient. It is not convenient to represent the input output in terms of 0 volt, 5 volts. So we are just renaming this 0 volt, something known as logic 0. We are renaming this 5 volt, something known as what? We are naming this as what? Logic 1. So instead of saying this is 0 volt, 5 volt or low level, high level, it is always in practice, we say it is the input is logic 0, input is logic 1, something like this. So instead of saying in terms of electrical parameters, voltage and all, we are just naming this is logic 0 and logic 1. So if this is the convention we are following in the entire subject, this kind of convention is what we mean by a positive logic system. Positive logic system. What is the meaning of positive logic system is that if the signal, in the digital signal, if low level corresponds to logic 0 and high level corresponds to logic 1, this kind of convention what you mean by what? Positive logic system. It means if I am writing positive logic system, it means there must be something known as negative logic system. So what is that actually? So a negative logic system is of course the opposite thing to this. So what we'll do is, here it is again the low level corresponds to 0 volt, high level corresponds to 5 volts. But here it is entirely opposite to this. So wherever it is low level 0 volt is there, we say this is what? Logic 1, we say this is something known as logic 0. If this kind of convention we are following, this is something known as negative logic system. Once again, the signal comprises of two levels, low level, high level. If this is what the convention we are following, that is known as positive logic system. If this is what the convention we are following, this is known as negative logic system. Low level corresponds to logic 0, high level corresponds to logic 1, positive logic system. Low level corresponds to logic 1, high level corresponds to logic 0, constitute what? The negative logic system. But remember one point, here onwards, in the entire subject, we will by default assume that we are always working with the positive logic system. Unless until quoted in any kind of problem, any kind of question, we will never discuss regarding these kind of systems. Actually, you may think, like, what is the change is going to happen if I am changing these kind of things? I hope you have some basic idea, and anyway I will discuss in the course. Suppose, for example, I am saying the output of a particular system with respect to two variable A, B, if this is what Y, if I am saying, let us say that this is an OR gate kind of thing. So we may get the output equal to Y equal to A plus B. So if I am saying this is what the positive logic expression, then this is what the things is happening with respect to this kind of convention. However, if I am changing the negative logic system, if I am changing the positive to negative logic system, the same thing, but the expression will keep on changing here. So now this will be AB here, right, which corresponds to AND. So this is what the negative logic system. Positive to negative or something like this, there is a concept called dual expression, which is used to convert a positive logic expression to negative logic, negative to positive. Detail I will discuss in a detailed way in the Boolean algebra chapter. For the time being, you only take this as the fact that if you are changing a positive logic system to negative logic system, or vice versa, that is negative to positive, there will be change in the logic expression of the system here. So this point you should keep in your mind, right? So this is the only thing we should note from this discussion. So what I discussed so far, only two points to be remember, that is what you mean by positive logic system, what you mean by a negative logic system, and what you mean by a digital signal. So once again I am telling that by default, if nothing is mentioned, we are going to work with what? Positive logic system. Okay. So coming to the subject digital with respect to gate. So what are the chapters are there in the syllabus? Let me list down all this. So the first chapter what we are going to study is something known as number system. Second chapter what we are going to study is known as Boolean algebra. Actually this is number system and binary codes. It's a single chapter. We will take this. All the concept we will discuss in this chapter. Number system and binary codes. This is Boolean algebra. Then the third chapter is logic gates. The fourth chapter is K-map. The fifth chapter is something known as combinational logic circuit. Right? The sixth chapter is something known as sequential circuit or sequential logic circuit. So these are what the major content. And this much of syllabus has to be covered for all the branches, EC, electrical, instrumentation, as well as. Whereas coming to EC, electrical, instrumentation, there is an extension of this, where we need to learn some extra chapters, something known as data converters, where we discuss regarding A to D converter, D to A converters, After this, we have a chapter, something known as logic family. You might have heard the name RTL, DTL, TTL, all those things. Those all things will come in logic family. And there is something known as microprocessors. So these things are not for CS. Okay. Now, when I discuss regarding the weightage of the subject in the GATE syllabus, coming to ECE and instrumentation, we are getting almost 10 marks, 10 to 12 marks hardly we get in each year. Coming to electrical and CS, it is at max 4 to 5 marks. 5 is the best case, but beyond that we don't have this. So the weightage of this subject in these two branches is less, right? And even if in ECE and instrumentation, if you are getting around 10 to 12 marks, if you observe all the previous year papers, right? So almost out of, if there are full market 10, almost 90% of the questions we are getting from these chapters only. 90% of the questions we are getting from this chapter. Some rare questions they are asking from those. Meaning to say, weightage of these chapters, what I have written in these leads, are more important compared to those. So this is what the weight is, and this is what the chapters or syllabus, and these are the sequence by which I am going to cover the entire syllabus. One more thing, at the end of your preparation, if you are preparing all the subject well, you will come to a conclusion that this subject is the most easiest subject compared to remaining all subject in your syllabus. You take any other subject, this turns out to easier even if compared to mathematics also. So coming to technical point of view, technical paper if you compare, this is the easiest subject and scoring is very easy. And one more thing, like I hope all of you know this, prior to 2013, we are having a single set paper in each stream. Let's say CS, we have a single stream paper, ECE, single stream paper, right? But coming to this year, from 2014 onwards, ECE we are having 3 to 4 sets, CS also 3 to 4 sets, electric also 2-3 sets like this. So when this number of questions, question papers are increasing, earlier days what was happening is directly the questions were predictable. Like it was known to us from which chapter they will ask. Mostly they target this chapter only, sequential circuits. Mostly what you say, flip-flop, registers, counters, all those things. But because they have to create these many questions, now each and every chapter they are touching. If you see this year, this is the only chapter in which there is not a single question asked in any set. But remaining all chapters they have touched. But if you see in the previous history, before to 2013 onwards, these sections are very much negligible. But nowadays, they are touching each and every part. So, we should not think like this is important for exam, this is not important for exam. So, what I want to say is selective study, what you should do for the normal semester examination, that is not correct here. Right? Okay. So, without saying much of the story regarding this, let us come to the subject. Let us start. So first chapter what you are going to see is number system. Number system and binary codes. So number system I am taking. This chapter is very much important from CS student point of view. If you observe the previous year paper, definitely at least 1-2 mark question is there. Even this year also, out of 3 sets, in 2 sets, they have asked the question from this number systems. Number system means, normally the view of you people, the students, they think that we are only going to talk about the conversion. That's the binary to octal, octal to hexadecimal, these things compared to number systems. Of course, those things are there, but if you come to GATE exam point of view, we don't find a single question where they will ask, convert this binary to decimal or binary to octal. Because these things are very elementary things even in class 7 or 8 students also learning nowadays. How to convert binary to octal, octal to these all things. So anyway, as a continuation, I have to start from the scratch. And of course, even if these are this much simple things, but there are some hidden points are there that some of you who are learning the subject first time, that may be new for you. So without losing patience, so see that how do you proceed this subject. Now, whenever we are talking regarding a number, right? So remember, any number we are talking regarding, it is always having something known as a base or radix associated with this. So this B is what we mean by base, or this is also known as what? Radix. So first of all, let us see that what are the properties of this base, properties of base. See, this B, it is always a positive number, usually B value is greater than or equal to 2. I'll come to reason why I'm taking like this, B is greater than or equal to 2. Second point, if I'm saying that if a number is base B, it means that this comprises of B number of symbols ranging from 0 to B minus 1. So what I want to say, if I'm writing any number here N, let us say any arbitrary combination, if I'm denoting that is base B, it means that comprises of B number of symbols. So these things will be clear. Let me give you example. So let me note down this. A number having base B comprises of B number of digits or B number of symbols, whatever you say, ranging from 0 to B minus 1. This is very important point. So what I want to say is, suppose if I'm writing here this base is 5, it means that in this, it is meaning that if I'm writing 5 here, it means that we are talking regarding base 5 number system. So coming to this statement, a number having base B comprises of B number of symbol. So if you see the base 5 number, what I want to say is, you can write anything in between this bracket, but that comprises of only 5 different kind of symbol. So those symbols are the numbers are nothing but equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and 4. You cannot have 5 or 6 like this. If you write something like this, suppose if I am saying this is 236 and if you write here base 5, this is a blunder mistake you are doing here. Remember that. That is the point I want to tell. That if a number having base B that comprises of B number of symbol ranging from 0 to B minus 1. So if I am writing here 5, means at max this comprises of digit, the maximum digit is 4. It is not even 5. Even I cannot write something known as 235 base 5. This is also invalid representation. This is not valid. However, if I am writing here 4, 4, 4, 4, 100 number of 4, even base 5, this is absolutely correct. So the point is to remember that if I am writing here a base is B, it means the digit combination of maximum digit is B minus 1. So you remember this point, we'll use this point to solve some problems later on. Some good questions are there. Okay. So, and one more thing also I want to tell. That what about this statement? B is always a positive number. Okay, that is understood. That means if I want to represent minus 5, minus 4 like that, I cannot write here base is something like minus 5. It is not correct. We'll see how to represent the negative number. There is a concept called as complements. We'll see that later on. But why I am saying that B value is greater than or equal to 2 here? See, if I am writing here B value is 2, what it means? It means that this can take 2 value only or 2 symbols. Those are 0 and 1. Saying here it is 1, it is meaningless actually. There is nothing wrong actually. But if you write here it is 1, what it means? This comprises of zeros only, right? So if the base is 1, it means that it comprises of only, even if this cannot contain 1 also. So it is meaningless because you can only represent a single number that is 0. It is totally meaningless, right? So for all the, even if it is mathematically valid, but for all the practical purpose, we take the minimum base equal to 2. So that's why I am saying B has to be greater than or equal to 2. But as far as our subject is concerned, digital electronics, we are 99% of time we are dealing with base equal to 2, which we mean by what? A binary number system. So most of our discussion is on the base 2, where the entire thing will talk regarding 0 1 0 1 0 1, because the already things I told the region that input signal 0 volt 5 volt, we are naming that by what? 0 and 1 only. We don't have a digit 2, 3, 4 like this. Hardly you will see any other things in the entire subject, but most of the time we will be only talking regarding 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. So that is one point you should remember here. Okay, see one thing. Suppose if I am writing your base is B, it is known as B number system. But there are some particular value of this B which are very much popular. B equal to 2, B equal to 8, B equal to 10, B equal to 16. So these are what the popular number system we are using. Technically we say this is binary, octal number system, decimal number system, and this is hexadecimal number system. I hope I don't have to elaborate much. So this comprises of 0 to 1, this comprises of 0 to 7, this comprises of 0 to 9, this comprises of 0, 1 like this, up to how much? 15. But we cannot write 15 here, so we use symbolic notation after 10 onwards. So 10 is A, 11 is B, like that. So up to we go up to what? This is we are going up to F only, right? So these are what the normally we are following the convention. So these things is we are using this kind of number system popularly. We are using in the digital electronics. Whereas if you come to base 8 and base 16, these two are using in the various microprocessor coding. Of course, 8085 and 8086, there we are again using the mostly base 16s only, right? Whatever we write some codes, if you want to give some input, that is normally in the hexadecimal forms. But there are also some processor which also takes octal system as their input. And what about decimal system, where it is used? We the normal human being, in the day-to-day life, we are using what? The base 10 number system. Okay, so this what the information is known to you. But recently, in one of the PSU exam, one question came. What is the question is? See, they have given like this. In the base X number system, a number is represented as,9ABC, right? Then the minimum value, of X is how much? This was the question they have asked. In a base X number system, a number represented as 9ABC whose base is X, right? Then what is the minimum value of X? Normally, whenever we see the alphabets like ABC, the thought that strike to our mind direct immediately that X can be equal to 16, right? This is what the thought we get. But if you say 16 is the answer, this is a blunder mistake you are doing here. You should take care of the word, the minimum value. So this is what you should remember here, the minimum value of X. So already I told you, like if a base is B, then that can hold the digit how much? B minus 1 only. So I can say in this, what is the greatest digit or what is the greatest number here? This is C. 9 is 9, A is 10, B is 11, C is 12. So I can say X minus 1 has to be greater than equal to 12 only, right? This is 10, 11, 12. So X value is greater than equal to 13. So X can take any value. I can write this X can be 13, this X can be 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, like that I can write. But I want the minimum value. So definitely the value of X is equal to 13. It is not equal to 16. I hope this equation is also clear, because here if this comprises of 12, the minimum base has to be 13. I already told it cannot be 12 also, right? That's what the equation I have written here. X minus 1 has to be equal to 12. And you may think that why I am saying base 17, 18, 19 like this. Even if practically we never use the base like 17, 18, 19. Because whatever base that is sufficient for the present day applications. So we are restricting up to 16. But there can also exist the base which is greater than 16. But we never come across those kind of situations. So this is what a logical question you should remember. Option A will be given to you 16. But the answer will be 13 in this case. Because of this what minimum value. Maximum value someone asks, we cannot say what is the value. Right? It can be any value. Okay. Then, normally, whenever I am writing a number n, some digit combination, let us say 2, 4, C, something like this, and if this is the base is B, I am saying like this, a number n is represented in base B or base B number system. What this practically means, this kind of representation, something we mean by weighted number system. So what we are doing day-to-day life, the decimal number system, octal, hexadecimal, all these are known as weighted number system. What do you mean by a weighted number system is? Actually, if you say, if a number is 3456.98, this is what I am saying, this is base 10. Actually, this is representation, it is a shorthand notation for a polynomial. What it means is, actual form representation of this thing is, here you can take this a decimal point, 10 power 0, 1, 2, 3. So this is 3 into 10 power 3 with respect to this, plus 4 into 10 power 2, plus 5 into 10 power 1, plus 6 into 10 power 0, and this is 9 into 10 power of minus 1, plus 8 into 10 power of minus 2. So this representation what I have used, that is a shorthand notation or a shortcut representation of this entire big polynomial. It is very much clear, it is always not convenient to write this much of big polynomial, so we are representing like this. So in place of 10, if I am writing here 8, 8 power 3, 8 power 2, 8 power 1, 8 power 0 like this, then it has to be base 8. Of course, in this case, not possible because 9, 8 is there. If I am writing here, let us say, writing like something like 13, then I have to write here 13 power q, 13 power 2, 13 power 1, like this it means. You see here one thing, when I am taking this base is 10, right? So each digit is weighted by power of the 10. See, for example, this is 10 power 0, 10 power 1, 10 power 2. So each position, each digit is weighted by power of 10. So we say this has weighted number system. If you change this base to something else, now this 10 power, this will also be changed. So right, so this is what we mean by weighted number system. So whenever we write something like this, we should keep in mind that it is a shorthand notation or a shortcut notation of this big entire polynomial. You may think these things are known to you very well, but why I am repeating these concepts? Because knowing the concept and applying those to solve problems are entirely different. You wait for some time, after 10-15 minutes, I will take up on problems where this concept has to be used, but very rarely you people will get thought for that. Okay. Anyway, so this is what one point to be noted, that whenever we represent something, it is a shorthand notation for a polynomial. Okay. Now, let us see something known as conversion of number system. In fact, this chapter is the very interesting chapter because many interesting problems are there. Okay, so what we are doing in the conversion of number system chapter is that we are converting a particular radix into some other radix. For example, there a number will be given, n1 in base r1 or radix r1, then we are be asked to find the equivalent of this, what is this value, or if this is n2, then what is the value of n2. So that is what the thing we are going to do. But you know very well, most frequently in the day-to-day life application, we are dealing with the decimal number system only, right? Whatever we are dealing, all the arithmetic, all algebra, what we are doing in all the other subjects, those are in the decimal number systems only. But as already I told you, digital electronics means it is dealing with a binary number system. So mostly we will deal in a subject with respect to base 10 and base 2, decimal number system and the binary number system. Others are also used, but that is not much of interest to us. So whenever it comes to conversion of number system, I am dividing this into three categories. So first category I am writing here, that decimal to any other number system. Decimal to other number system, right? So what we are going to see in this category is, like a decimal number will be given to us. So this is base 10 and this is also given to us. Then we will be asked to find what is the equivalent of this into some base r. So this is also given to us. Under these circumstances, we need to find what is the value. Let's say, for example, base 10 to base 2, base 10 to base 3, base 10 to base 8, base 10 to base 16, like this kind of conversion that comes under this category. Why I have written the heading here, decimal to other number system, is, so whenever the problems comes under this category, decimal to others, the conversion procedure is same. We don't have to remember for base 10 to base 2 this, base 10 to base 3 this. That's why I'm classifying in this category. So I'm not going to take all examples. Let me just quickly give a review that how that this happens. Because already sometimes in 2004 or 6, some question came in instrumentation as well as CS also. If some of you think that we can solve these problems by using the calculators, calculator doesn't support all those things. I'll come to the reason why is it so. So let us see that suppose we have given a number 53.75. This is in the base 10. And we want to find what is the binary equivalent of this. So decimal to binary. So whenever we are given a number like this, to convert this, we have to follow two steps actually. We will take care of this integer part separately and we will take care of this fractional part separately. What is the procedure to be followed to convert this integer part is repeated division with required base. This one, repeated multiplication with required base. So let me solve this quickly. So what we are going to do is we are going to take 53 separately and 0.75 separately, and we'll by following this we'll convert that and finally write the answer. So let us talk regarding the integer part first here. So what I'm saying is that repeated division with the required base is 2 here. That's why I have repeated divided by 2. If it could have been 7, then the division with respect to 7 only. You know these things from 10th class onwards. You are learning these things. So this is 1. So the remainder is 0. The remainder is 1. The remainder is 0. The remainder is 1. The remainder is 1. So the answer what you are getting here is 110101. And I hope all of you know like how to write the answer of this. We have to move from bottom to top to write the binary equivalent. We'll write the answer after a moment. But now let us talk regarding the fractional part. So what you're going to do with respect to fractional part is the fractional part what we have, that's equal to 0.75. So as I'm telling, repeated multiplication of the required base. So required base is 2 here. So multiply this with 2. So how much we are getting? This equal to 1.5. So what you do in all the cases is that don't take this integer part, you take this to outside, and what is remaining you repeatedly multiply that. In other words, it is convenient to represent in some other format like this. So what you do, you multiply 0.75 with 2. So how much you are getting is, you are getting this as 1.5. So while proceeding to next step, you don't take this 1, you take this 1, make it 0 always. Always this is the process has to be followed. So whatever the integer part, that has to be taken out. What is remaining? Again, we will multiply 2 here. So this is how much you are getting. This is 1.0. Once again, this one I am taking out. So I am making this as 0. If I am multiplying again by 2, I am getting this as 0.0. And here afterwards, there is no meaning to carry out the procedure because repeatedly we are going to get 0.0. So as I told, like to represent the integer part, we have to move from bottom to top. For this, we have to move from what? Top to bottom. So while writing the answer, so what we should do is starting from this side 110101, this is the radix point is here, and with respect to this is 11. It doesn't matter how many 0 you put here, so this is in the base 2. Now who are already acquainted with the calculator, you may think that we will solve this problem in calculator. Calculator will definitely give you this answer, this integer part, but you can try in calculator. That will never give you the what is the answer of this fraction. And what is the reason that why calculator doesn't support the conversion of this fractional part, that also I'll explain after a moment. But this is what the procedure to be followed. Okay, fine. So I hope this is okay, nothing to explain actually. So now let us take the next problem. So this is what the procedure will be remaining same. So if this could have been to be 7, here division by 7, there multiplication by 7. I'll take another example so that you will get further clarity. But let me tell you one good point here that may be new for you. Coach, it's a computer science question in 2001, I think so. So what they have asked is that 0.15 is given in base 10 and they have asked what is the binary equivalent of this. Same model only. Because this comprises of only fraction, so repeated multiplication has to be carried out. So 0.15 into 2, 0.30 into 2, 0.60 into 2, 1.20. So in this case 0, 0 we are getting. So this 0 is here, this 0 is here, this one I am taking here, I am making this as 0 into 2. So how much I will get? 0.40 into 2, 0.80 into 2, 1.60. This one I will take outside into 2. This is again 1.20, something like this. A point out here that if you compare the previous problem and this problem, that whenever I am dealing with that 0.75, after two step multiplication I got the answer as 0.00 and I stopped there, right? But you can see here that if I am keep on multiplying by 2, by 2, by 2, it is confirmed that 0.20 repeat here, there is no chance that at any moment we are going to get 0, 0, right? So in the earlier case, wherever we are getting 0, 0, we are stopping there. But in this case, you see, it is a non-ending series. It is meaning that the exact binary equivalent of a fractional part is may not be possible to represent always. In other words, what I want to say is, it is always possible to represent an integer into its exact binary equivalent, but it may not be always possible to represent a fractional part in its binary equivalent, because the number of digits required to represent this number is infinite. Because you see here, it is a non-ending series. If I am thinking I will represent by 0, 0, 1 like this, how many digits I will get? I will get infinite digits because this is a non-ending series. And that is the reason that why calculator doesn't support that the conversion of the fractional part. Because after all, calculator is programmed by a human being. By pen and paper itself, it is not possible to say what is the answer, how it can be programmed. And anyway, calculator cannot represent infinite number of bits, right? So that is the reason why calculator doesn't support this kind of conversions. So in that question, one of the option was given, cannot be obtained exactly. Option D was given like in CS gate paper. So that is the answer for this question. So be sure that if it is integer part, it is always possible to convert. But if it is fractional part, it may or may not be, that depends on the integer. For 0.75, it was okay, but for 0.15, it is not okay. Okay. Right. So, let me take another example. Let's say 682.15. Let us say this is in the base 8. Sorry, base 10, let us say. We want to convert into its hexadecimal equivalent. Writing here 8 is a blunder mistake, right? Because 8 is there. If you write like this, it's a blunder mistake. So let us say this is 10. What is the procedure then? Now once again the same procedure. 682 is there, right? So integer part separately and the fractional part separately. So 682, this has to be divided by what? 8 only. So how much it will go? 8 is 64, 4, 2, 8, 5 is 42. Then with respect to 8, this is 10, this is 5. With respect to 8, this is 1, this is 2. With respect to 8, this is, so we'll be stopping here, right? We'll be stopping here. So I think the calculation is correct. So coming to this, multiply by 8. So this is 1.20. This one you have to take out. So you take this is 0. Again multiply by 8. It is 1.60. This one you take out. Make this is 0. Again multiply by 8. So how much you will get? You will get 4.80. Right? This 4 you take out. Make it is 0. Again multiply by 8. So you will get 6.40. You take this 6 out. Make it is 0. Again multiply by 8. So how much you will get? 3.20. Again this 3. So it is also clear that this also a non-ending series. So the problem we are getting, whenever we have to deal with the fractional part, then we are getting the problems. So to write the answer here, so I will say this is equal to 1252, radix point will be here because we are going in this way, in this side this way, 11403, something like this. This is also non-ending series. So this is what one category of problems. So let us take a break and we will see some further problems based on this. Okay, let's see the queries. Prabhakaran, sir, please tell me reference book for digital electronics. Also tell any book for practicing problems. I think this is a common question. I'll delve it. Amrita Goroi, is it possible that value of V is 1345? Why not? Already I told, value can be anything. Then again, so you're asking if V is 1345 exists, then where is the application of those number systems? I'll say only one thing. This is only for fun we are doing here. If you say 1, 3, 4 like this, just for problem solving purpose, we may use that. But practically, as of my knowledge, no, as specifically this has to be 3, 4 like that. No. Silpa, 0.68 base 10 to convert into base 2. 0.68 base 10 to convert base 2. What is the problem? You repeatedly multiply by 2. Right? Procedure I already told. Again, Amrita Gorai, in case of fraction part, how many digits will take at the time of number system conversion? In case of fraction part, how many digits we will take at the time of number system conversion? It's up to you, 3, 4, 5. You can stop and you can, as I did there, dot, 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 I put it, right? So you do for 2, 3 time multiplication. If you are observing that the pattern is changing, there is no meaning to continue. You can write that it is not possible to get the exact value. I hope this is clear. Again, Amrita, in case of fraction part, how many digits we will take at the time of number system? Same thing I answered. Then Bharat, Bharat is saying, in converting 682.15 to base 8, why didn't we get the answer 1252? Why didn't we get? We get, right, 1252. I have not written that. I think I have written 1252. Yeah, the answer is 1252. If I have forgot to, please, you can rectify that. It has to 1252. Silpa, sir, you told that fractional part, just a minute. Silpa is saying, sir, you told that fractional part with repeated base multiplication, how many times we have to do? It depends on digit after floating points? No, not like the Silpa. It's not like 1, 2. Of course, after 3, 4 multiplication only, you are going to know that whether is it really repeating or not. It's not a rule like after 3, 4. You can do through 3, if you observe, put dot, dot, dot. Saurav, which book to follow for digital electronics for electrical stream? Okay, I'll talk regarding this. Prabhakaran, what is the main advantage of using digital system? Speed less or less noise? What are the advantages? There are many advantages, like power is power dissipation is less, speed is more, secure information storage is easy. There are many things are there. See, these are what I am saying. This course what we are discussing, this is a purely gate exam oriented course. Our 100% focus will be on the what? To how to solve the logical problem of the gates. So when it comes to application point of view, we are not going to talk anything regarding applications. So whichever is not at all relevant from gate point of view, I'll try to avoid those things as much as possible, right? But it is of course here, what is needed, I will not leave a single point. You wait for that. So you can see those things. Sushant is asking, can base be a negative value or a fraction value? Of course not. Already I told. I have written the property of base. You can check that. That is won't be. Okay. So many of you are asking regarding the base, right? What is that? Books. So books means the first preference that you should take here is a book is given by 3% Tosi, Moss, and one more person is there, something Tosi. But this book is well known by Tosi only. This comes under the Pearson publication, right? So this book you can refer if you want to purchase one book. This is the best book. Of course, apart from this, all over world, everyone follows this book. Maurice Mano, this is also a good book. But I always prefer this compared to this. But when you are asking regarding the books, what will do with the books? Then I will say one thing, the basic difference between the self-study and the coaching, what we are doing here. The basic difference is that if I am giving a book, you may not be in a position to decide what to study, what not to study. Let's say for example, this book size, it's almost around 900 pages, if you see. It's also, the PDF is also available. Many of you may not have heard this book name, but it's a very excellent book. Almost all the concept I learned from this book only. But even if it's 900 pages, hardly we have to read, I think, around 300 to 400 pages like this. So that's the point, what to study, what not to study. So deciding that by self is very difficult. So after training this repeatedly here, we have that idea. So for reference point of, you can take this book. This is a nice book, right? And when it comes to solving the problem parts, as you are saying, then it is the best way to do in that is not only this subject, any subject you take, only solve the previous year gate exam papers. Whether you are from EC, electrical, any background, solve the previous year gate problems. Because those problems are really some level problems are there. You need to have some thought before answering that. Chota mota problem will not get in those kind of things. So that's the reason you solve the standard problems. And the approach what I'm going to follow, concept will be taken from this book only. But while it comes to problems, 99% of the problems are the previous year gate problems only I will solve. So you should also be tuned to that. That's why I'll tell you that you also tune according like that's been solve the previous year problem. Attend the class, solve previous problem. That's what. Then finally, Abhishek is asking, sir, how will represent the non-ending fractions? It's not possible, right, Abhishek? I told. It is not possible to represent that I told. There is no doubt on it. Okay, we'll continue the session. Now,